How many of you present here have donated blood so far? Well, kudos and a big thank you for myself. Anyways, good morning to one and all. I am AARTI from Kamineni Institute of Medical Sciences, Nagpur, and my study for the day is knowledge, attitude, practice, and blood donation in rural and urban areas of Kalyan. Coming to introduction, India's organized voluntary blood donation history, it dates back to 1942. Yet, lack of ample extent of blood donation is one of the most pressing concerns, even today. According to the latest WHO report, India still lacks 1.1 million units per year. And to overcome this, we need more number of voluntary, non-remunerated donors. The average blood donation rate is 9 times lower in a developing country because they are plagued with ignorance, misconceptions, and fears about blood donation process, and also they lack facilities for the same. In Telangana state, it is the second highest number of districts without any blood banks. There are 10 of them. And Nalgonda is a district with one of the least number of blood banks, standing higher only to Mahabubnagar. So accordingly, my objectives are to assess and compare the knowledge, attitude and practice on blood donation, and to identify the barriers for the voluntary blood donation among the rural and urban areas. Coming to the methodology, it was a community-based cross-sectional study done on 250 subjects ranging from 18 years to 60 years. The subjects were interviewed after selecting them using a systemic randomized sampling technique, and we gave them a pre-designed, pre-tested sentence structure questionnaire after taking a verbal consent form. These were my operational definitions, and coming to the results, this is the social demographic profile. Let's head to what I asked for knowledge. Around 88.4% of people had heard of blood donation. And other questions which were minimum age limit, whether they're aware of the time gap between donations, and so on and so forth. So what I noticed was people in urban areas had a higher level of knowledge. Then coming to the attitude, 77.6% people had a positive attitude towards this. But 37.55% wanted to donate only to their family members. 72% would like to encourage others, which is good for us. And around 50% were not in favor of accepting money for donating blood. And around 70% said that they do not believe, I mean, they are against the practice of donating people belonging to only their caste or creed. Coming to the attitude, irrespective of the area, everyone had a positive attitude towards donating the blood. And caste-wise, as you can expect, maybe due to the inhibitions present in the rural areas, you found that people there were little more inclined towards donating people of their own caste. Practice, these were the questions I asked. Have you ever donated? If yes, how many times? If no, why? And the member of voluntary, are you a member of voluntary blood donation group or not? And disappointing, only 10 of them were members of the group. The reasons for not donating mainly were no opportunity and fear about the donation process. Coming to the practice, people in the rural areas had a lesser number of practice. Coming to, as we can expect, people with higher knowledge would have more amount of more positive attitude, and same with people with positive attitude and the practice of donation. So this is how we got the source of information, mainly being television, radio and newspaper. And blood donation stuff was one of the least from where we got from now. Coming to the conclusions, as you can see, 68% had adequate knowledge and 77.6% had positive attitude. Still, only 16% had donated so far. Lack of opportunity and fear were the two leading factors, and only 21% were willing to donate the unknown person they need. And 50% were not in favor of accepting money. And electronic and print media were the main source of information. The recommendations would be, we have to enlighten the public and organize frequent health camps because there are lack of facilities. Then educate the illiterate, thereby decreasing their inhibitions and fears regarding blood donation. Teaching the merits of blood donation and inspiring young adults from school level. Improvement of facilities involved in the blood donation process and encouraging the active involvement of NGOs for spreading the awareness. This study was approved by ICMR this year. These are my references.
You told it as a comparative study between urban and rural areas, right? So sample, how did you divide it equally among urban and rural?
No, sir, 127 in rural and 123 in urban, sir. And then as I said, the systemic variance sampling, how I did was, the ward numbers we used for 3, 7, 9 and 10, we went to a particular ward. At the end, it's like, for example, Chelsea, that was my ward, which had 800 houses. So we did 800 by the 123. So that would come up to 7 houses. So from the entrance, every 7th house was asked for the questions.
Okay. The house means all the participants in the house or whoever was the respondent?
One number.
So how did you select that one number? If suppose 4 people are in your age group of 18 to 60 years available in the house, how did you select that one person?
Sir, actually when we went, most of the time it was in the morning, so most of them were females available.
Okay.
The females there, and as such, we asked for a verbal consent. So as you can expect, the older people were like, we are not interested, let's just move on. So most of the time, we found the middle aged people who were agreeing to the verbal consent. So whoever agreed to the verbal consent, we went ahead and
did. So if 2 people went ahead in the same house, what did you do? If 2 people wanted in the same house?
Sir, we did not.
You did not, yeah. And you told you calculated using a formula, Z square,
yes.
4P cube by L square, that is what you used. But you should have used it separately for urban and rural, no? Separate formula. Why did you combine it and then again split it to 127 and 123?
Now we'll take a short break for 5 minutes and we'll be back.